Today on this special build edition of the AI Show, join us to hear from Egg Omorogwe, program manager on the Azure Machine Learning team. Egg will explain how notebooks in Azure Machine Learning Studio is a new, first-in-class notebook authoring experience packed with features that make it easier to create, edit, and collaborate. Make sure you tune in.
Hi, my name is Abel Margwe. I'm a program manager on the Azure Machine Learning team here at Microsoft. Thank you for joining us today at Build and taking the time to watch this video. In this session, I'm going to walk you through all the new and exciting features coming to Azure Machine Learning Studio. So let's get started. You're probably wondering, what exactly are these Studio notebooks and what are their benefits? Studio notebooks are a notebook editor and file explorer that lives inside the Azure Machine Learning Studio. Studio notebooks are fully compatible with Jupyter, which means you can bring in any Jupyter notebooks and it just works. With Studio notebooks, we strived for a first-in-class notebook editing experience with some of the best code editing features. Every single code cell is packed with the Monaco editor, the same editor that powers the popular Visual Studio Code. Each cell also has Intellisense for code suggestions and error highlighting, as well as a nice new gather feature, which cleans up your notebook in seconds. While developing Studio notebooks, we made sure we made the collaboration experience seamless. We will be introducing a live co-editing experience, which makes working remotely with colleagues easier and collaboration on notebooks effortless. And lastly, this experience is all integrated inside the Azure Machine Learning Studio, giving you quick access to all your machine learning assets. Enough talking, let me show you. In this demo, I will show you how a data scientist or developer can easily edit and run a Jupyter notebook without leaving the Azure Machine Learning Studio. I will pause at various points throughout the demo to explain to you the new features and why they're important. I'll be working with a notebook that uses a diabetes dataset to predict the diabetes disease progression using key indicators like age, gender, and BMI. This is a common data science example and can be found in the Azure Machine Learning tutorial documentation. For this example, I will show you a typical data science workflow and how Azure Machine Learning notebooks can make you and your team more productive.
I'm here in my Azure Machine Learning workspace, a one-stop shop for all my machine learning needs. In this workspace, I can easily share all my machine learning assets with my teammates. To start this experiment, let me click on Notebooks. Here, I can browse all my files and the files of others on my team, making it extremely simple to collaborate. With Studio Notebooks, I can start working with a Jupyter notebook directly in my workspace and have easy access to any of my experiment details, datasets, models, and more stored in the Azure Machine Learning Studio. I'm going to start building the diabetes experiment by opening the notebook I've been working on. I'll minimize the File Explorer and the other menu so I have more space to work with. First, I'll start by connecting to my workspace. Before I run the first cell, I realized that I'm currently connected to a machine that's a bit overpowered for this experiment. With Studio Notebooks, I can easily stop this compute to save some money and switch to a cheaper compute. As you can see, I can hit the stop button here, use the compute dropdown, and switch to a smaller compute, and then run the first cell.
As you just saw, I started typing in the Monaco editor, the same popular editor that powers Visual Studio Code. This is now embedded inside every single code cell. Before running the cell, I used the notebook toolbar to control my Azure Machine Learning compute. These computes are called compute instances in the Azure Machine Learning context, and this is what is used to execute my notebook cells. Compute instances can be easily created and switched to run your notebooks because the notebooks are stored in the shared file storage that all the computes have access to. In the scenario I just showed you, the convenient compute dropdown in the toolbar showed me the status of my computes, as well as details about that compute. Backed by the power of the Azure cloud, I can easily spin up a new GPU or CPU compute instance that meets all my computing needs right inside the Studio notebook. Lastly, we added a cell toolbar to every cell, making it faster to do some cell operations, such as moving the cell, clearing the cell's outputs, or converting the cell to markdown.
As I walked through this experiment, I noticed I forgot to define the experiments properly. Let me hover over this experiment module. With Intellisense, I can see the code snippets right there. Let me try that out. By hitting Control and Space, I can activate the Intellisense suggestions. Now I know all I have to type in now is my workspace name, as well as the name of this experiment. I'm gonna go ahead and name this Diabetes Experiment 1. And let me run this cell.
The Intellisense experience you just saw is using the same language server that powers VS Code. As most know, Intellisense is a real productivity booster for anyone typing code, and even more impactful within a notebook canvas, fitting well with a user's fast-paced and iterative workflow. Features like auto-completions, inline error highlighting, and code suggestions can make iterating through a notebook much quicker.
In this cell, I've already written some code to load the dataset, to do some data transformation, and split the data into training and test set using the train-test-split function. To make sure I did everything properly, I'll preview the data frame and confirm I imported all the data correctly. I could also hover over the diabetes package to see if I imported everything properly. As you can see, it looks about right. Thank you, Intellisense. When looking at an unfamiliar data set, I like to look at the types of columns and statistics of the variables. Nice, this looks good to me. Overall, the data looks good and there are no obvious outliers. Now I know my data is good, I want to build a script that trains ridge models in a loop through different hyperparameter alpha values. Oops, the Intellisense is telling me that there's an error in my code. Oh, I see. It looks like I forgot the EL at the end of model. Let me put that right back in. Okay, cool. It looks like everything should be good now. Nice. When training multiple models like this, it is easy to lose track of what models I trained and how I trained them. I know in Azure Machine Learning Studio, there's a way to track all my runs and share my experiments with my teammates. However, I don't quite remember. You know what? Let me ask Leah to help unblock me. She's really good at this stuff. Leah's one of my teammates and she has access to my workspace. Let me quickly send her my problem and a link to my notebook via Teams so we can collaborate on the notebook together. Let me just open up Teams. Let me type her. Now that I have sent the link to Leah, she should be able to click this link and get access to my notebook, and we can collaborate on it together.
In this next part of the demo, I'm going to give you a short preview into a very exciting feature we're releasing later this year. In a future release of Studio Notebooks, we're going to introduce the concept of live co-editing inside a notebook. By simply sharing a link to your notebook with a colleague, they can have access to your notebook and help you debug as well as unblock you from different issues. Features like this make it easier for teams to work together, especially when everybody's working from home. This collaboration feature is using Microsoft's Fluid Framework to enable a seamless collaboration experience. From our customer research, we know that collaborating on a notebook is something many want, especially in this space with a lot of newcomers.
So I see Abe has sent me a message asking for help tracking an experiment. Following the link he shared, I land in co-editing mode on a notebook. I can see that Abe is also working on this notebook by his status icon here in the top right. As I scroll through the notebook, I can also see which cells Abe has already run by this output indicator. I want to find where Abe is currently working in this notebook. And I find his cursor indicator here in this cell, which tells me this will be a good place to start in order to help him. I'll take a quick look at the code he has written so far. Okay, it looks good, and I can see what he is trying to do. But in order to track his custom metrics for this experiment, we will need to define and log a few variables. I have done something similar before, so I will bring over those lines of code. First, we need to define the run variable, which will let us log the custom metrics. We'll also log each alpha value. And we'll log the RMSE value. Logging these values will let us capture the accuracy of the experiment. Finally, we want to upload the model file so that the model associated with this run can be viewed in the experiments page. And lastly, we'll make sure to complete the run. Okay, so that should do it for the code changes. I'll leave Abe a note in the last cell of the notebook, letting him know where to go next. Because this will just be a comment, I don't want this to be a code cell. I'll use the cell toolbar to convert this cell to Markdown, which is more appropriate. Great, so hopefully this will help Abe move forward with tracking his experiment.
As I was watching, I saw everything Leah added, and it looks like I'm ready to track my experiment. Let me run this cell, so I can track my experiment. Wow, Leah even left me a note telling me to go to the experiments tab to see this experiment. Let's go there right now. So I'll just open this up, go to the experiments tab, and open up my experiment. Diabetes experiment 1. Nice! I can see all 10 training runs and the metrics from the experiment that Leah helped me track show up all right here, just a few clicks away.
As you just saw, I was on the experiments page and I was able to see the runs executed by the notebooks. I saw all the individual runs in the experiment and all the custom logged values. When training models at scale with hundreds and even thousands of separate runs, this page makes it very easy to see every model you've trained, specifically how they were trained and how each unique metric changes over time. The best part is that with Studio Notebooks, everything is integrated and you could easily switch back to the notebooks in all the same workspace without switching your tabs or even opening a new window. It really streamlines the workflow and makes you more productive.
I did some exploration earlier that didn't lead to anything. Let's clean up this notebook so that I can keep only the cells that were necessary to produce the final output. With the gather feature, I can do just that. I'll click here and then click gather. This feature will clean up my notebook. After clicking that button, a notebook with only the necessary code is created. Let me show you that notebook. Wow, as you can see, this notebook only has the necessary code needed to produce the final output. Now this experiment is complete and my notebook is much cleaner. With Gather, my life just got a whole lot easier.
In a data scientist interactive notebook workflow, you try things out in various cells, looking at various outputs before you settle on the code that you actually want to keep. With the Gather technology, a single click on the chosen cell creates a cleaned up notebook with only the code that matters. Gather does this by doing an automated dependency analysis on your notebook, ensuring that essential code is kept but removing any irrelevant pieces.
Thanks for staying through this session and watching the demo. As you just saw, Azure Machine Learning is a great place to work with notebooks. I was able to start work with my Diabetes Jupyter notebook. Then I was able to start coding quicker with the improved code cell editor using features like Intellisense. When I got stuck, my teammate Leah was able to unblock me with the live co-editing feature. Then after running my experiment, I could easily track the experiment in the integrated Azure Machine Learning experiments page. And lastly, after all of that, I was able to clean up my notebook quite quickly with the gather function. If you want to try these new features out and read more about Studio Notebooks, please follow the links on the screen. The Studio Notebooks team and I want to thank you for watching this, and we hope you become more productive with Azure Machine Learning Studio and the Studio Notebooks.